Touchdown, Rattlers. Carried by number 7, A.J. Cruz. Extra point attempt is no good. Ball carried by number 2, Dwayne Brooks.
Number 70 offense is eligible. 70 is eligible.
Touchdown, Thunder! Pass caught by number 6, Jared Perry. Fans, thunder up! Extra point attempt is good for the lead, 7-6, Kevin Gessley. Fans for a mouth. Foul carried by number 7, AJ Cruz. Stopped by number 4, Osagie Odiasi.
By rule, the ball will be placed on the 3-yard line as a receiving team was not successful advancing the ball out of the end zone. First down.
Pass complete to number 1, Rod Windsor. Fans, the ball's in your house. Let's get loud. Pass incomplete. Intended for number 15, Kerry Reed.
Holding defense. Number 13. Penalties after this goal. It is also an automatic first down.
Ball carried by number 9, Michael Benson. Touchdown, Arizona. Ball carried by number 9, Michael Benson. Extra point is good. From the kicker, number 17, Fabrizio Scaccia. Fans, Thundersnacks. Ball carried by number 2, Dwayne Brooks.
I thought there that Robert Hayes, his own teammate, was trying to tackle him there for a minute.
So that's Reggie Smith, the referee. Marquise Jackson, who isn't afraid to mix it up.
Robert Hayes
at any time.
Robert Hayes went. Yeah, he's not. He's a great player. Robert Hayes went for the block there, and the guy who was going to block fell down. And he
first quarter, Portland Thunder Arena football action for you on 750-1029 the game. It's a first down and 10 at their own 8-yard line. Portland down 13-7. A rally, a three-step drop quickly across the middle. Finds McKeon Lacey at about the 16-yard line. It's a pickup of 8 yards. And the tackler, give credit to number 20, Jeremy Kellum out of Middle Tennessee State.
Yeah, Jeremy Kellum's a great player for this big time, I guess, Arizona Rattlers defense. But I like those plays over the middle, just a quick little slant route for McKeon Lacey. He's a big body. You know, you're not going to really overthrow or underthrow him unless you really are errant on your pass. So I like that play call here early in this game.
Second down and 2 at the 16 for Portland. Quick pass out to the right hand flat to number 2, Dwayne Brooks. Breaks a couple of tackles. He's got the first down and a lot more into Arizona territory at the 23-yard line. Dwayne Brooks, tough to bring down, showing some toughness there.
He is in a quick screen pass out to the outside. And you know, if you can get blockers in front of Dwayne Brooks, a lot like a kick return, it's going to be the same situation where Brooks can find a seam and get down the field in a hurry. One thing I noticed, though, he had a couple of fumbles a few weeks ago, did Dwayne Brooks. Not, you know, taking care of the football, really had both hands wrapped around that ball, not going to let the Rattlers defenders rip that away.
Jeremy Kellum, who was involved in the tackle, slow to get up, and now he looks a little shaky as he heads toward the Arizona Rattlers bench. And it looks like number 21, Marcus Smith, a 6-foot, 200-pounder out of Nevada, Reno, will be in the backfield for Arizona. And Kellum, that would be a big significant injury if he cannot return. But he's still walking very slowly to the Arizona Rattlers bench to our right.
Jeremy Kellum is a top 5 in the league in tackles, over 61 on the season.
Rally brings the Thunder up, back to pass. He floats it out, a little screen pass to Joe Martinez. He gets about 6 yards, loses his helmet. But a nice catch by, he's got good hands, 6'2", 325 out of USC. Where's number 70, John Martinez? And he's fun to watch when he gets in the open field.
Yeah, he really is. He's a guy, he's hurdled a couple of guys this season, and that's why Coach Owensy likes giving him the ball, because he knows he's going to make plays. He's going to take care of the football, he's not going to fumble, and you're almost guaranteed to get at least 5 or 6 yards, just like he did on that possession.
Second down and 5 at the Rattlers' 18-yard line. Perry in motion, rally back to pass, now throws over to Brooks in the left-hand flat. He gets to the 15, he continues to go, but he's out of bounds. Cruz knocks him out of bounds, number 7. Close to a first down, but I'm going to say it's about a yard and a half short, Brian.
And Jared Perry there a little bit frustrated. I believe the play call was for him. He just had a slant route over the middle. He ended up beating his man, Ron, and was wide open. But Rowley, the safe play, checked down to Dwayne Brooks, made sure they got at least a couple yards out of it.
And Perry, I think, lets Kyle Rowley know, hey, I was open.
Like every receiver in
Wait,
the history
well, I always did it. Come on, if they didn't throw to me.
You're always open.
Perry's going to be the guy in motion this time. Third down and 1.5. Rally looking for Perry in the end zone, and he overthrows him. He beat his man, but the ball was a little beyond as Kellum is back in the game for Arizona.
Yeah, and that's big for them that he's able to come back in, and now it's a 4th and short.
What are you going to call, Brian? Short 4th and 1, the big play right now. You want to keep this momentum going.
You know what I like? I like a run play here up the middle. Martinez has proven time and time again he can take care of business. Either that or even a quick screen out to Dwayne Brooks. You know, give him an opportunity in space to get 3 or 4 yards here and move the sticks. You know, you can go for gold if you want, but at this point you need to move the chains. The Thunder have struggled on 4th and short situations this year.
They have. Here we go. 5:51 to go in the first quarter. Rally back to pass. Fires across the middle. It's complete to Dwayne Brooks for a first down. He's brought down at the 7-yard line of Arizona. Brought down by Marquise Floyd, number 19, a DB out of West Georgia.
A really good job by Kyle Rowley to find his man. Dwayne Brooks just settles in between 2 defensive backs. A quick comeback route, and it's a nice job to get the yards necessary there for the first down, right in between 2 defenders.
First down and goal at the Arizona 7. It's 13-7 Rattlers. Portland trying to tie and possibly regain the lead here. Perry in motion, rally back to pass in the pocket, forced out of the pocket, rolling to the right. He throws it into the stands. Souvenir for, looks like, oh, some fan wearing khaki shorts, throws it to his kids. That's one of the things about he had quite a battle going on there, but he was going down the stairs instead of up the stairs. He was able to get to that ball first. But the bottom line is Kyle Rowley, instead of possibly throwing an INT, threw it away.
Yeah, good job by the Rattlers secondary on that play. No one was open. Entaj Hawthorne was coming after Rowley, and Rowley actually kind of climbed up the pads to get away to make sure there wasn't a cheap late hit behind him.
Perry in motion, running toward the line of scrimmage. And it is a pitch out to John Martinez, and he is unable to get any traction, and he is knocked down for perhaps a two-yard loss. Glasper, number 94, was in there. Tyree Glasper, 6'3", 270 out of North Carolina A&T, and it is a two-yard loss back to the nine. It'll be third and goal at the nine.
It's the big-time shoulder tackle. A guy of his height and his stature in Martinez, you know, you're not going to be able to wrap him up high and expect – you know, to stop forward momentum, but that time just a nice shoulder-to-shoulder tackle to force him down. No gain, loss of two.
The Keon Lacy, the big guy, maybe we're going to see him try to catch the pass here. Let's see what happens. Rowley fires to the end zone, though, and it's Jared Perry. He bobbles it and catches it. Touchdown, Portland Thunder, Jared Perry. Wow, great catch.
That was a great catch. Our Keith Brown actually got away with a hold on that play. He was all over Perry as Perry cut away towards the corner of the end zone for that score. And he did bobble it up against the pads, but I don't believe it hit those Les Schwab upper pads, which are automatically out of bounds. If the ball hits your regular pads down below that are about 5 feet tall, the ball is still legal and in play.
Coach Guy not happy. He went over and talked to the referee.
His hand is in his pocket.
He may ask for, yes, indeed he is. It's going to be a review before Portland could get off the extra point. Kevin Gessling trying to get things rolling there, but Coach Kevin Guy wants this looked at by Reggie Smith. So Reggie Smith, who wears number 67, wears the white hat. He's trotting down to the Portland bench, which is to our right. If you think about the Moda Center, it's basically, if you were to be at the Trailblazer game, you'd go through that same tunnel where the media head into the media room. That's where the big screen is for Reggie Smith.
But and I think the real question is, Ron, I don't know about you, but a lot of times you've had these calls that are iffy one way or another, but ultimately there hasn't been a camera angle. Now, they do a great job here, obviously, at the Moda trying to get you the best angles, but if there's nothing definitive, they're not going to be able to overturn this. Now, we're not seeing the play here on the Jumbotron, but, you know, unless it hit those upper pads, that ball should be in play. So we'll find out. He obviously bobbled it. There's no doubt about that. He had a great
He did bobble it, but he brought it back in.
And this hurts if this one is overturned, especially since Arkeith Brown got away with a big-time hold.
They'll probably see that on the replay, though.
Yeah, and unfortunately, you can't retroactively,
no,
you know, add a penalty, but it was a pretty obvious hold.
By the way, this is Keep Oregon Green Night, and on the 21st, it's going to be Star Wars Night, which should be interesting. We'll bring your Star Wars costume.
Jar Jar Binks in the house.
It's Father's Day.
Excited about that.
So Darth Vader, he was the father of, wasn't he the father of Luke Skywalker?
Hey, spoiler alert.
No, that's like an old Star Wars thing from like three movies ago. What are you talking about?
I don't think I was born when that movie came out.
Right.
Yeah, Darth is going to be in the house probably.
Oh, yeah, they'll all be here.
Maybe so Mark Hamill.
Yeah, if you got kids, I mean, with the big Star Wars movie coming out at Christmas, I mean, this is just part of a big Disney buildup.
Is that when it's coming out? Okay.
Yeah.
I don't think I've seen too many of the Star Wars.
There is a trailer you can watch.
Okay, well, I'll have to check it out.
Yeah, check it out. I watched the Jurassic World trailer today.
Yeah, well,
I know the movie came out today.
Come on, guys, it's not Dinosaur Night.
They should have done, yeah. We should have dressed up as T-Rexes.
Yeah, a little Stegosaurus in the middle of the field. I mean, that wouldn't be distracting at all.
Not at all, but it's a nice crowd here at the Moda Center. They did get out the water bottles that are pretty cool. I don't know if you had a chance to see one.
Touchdown.
There you go. Touchdown, Portland Thunder. So it is a touchdown, and with 3:13 to go in the first quarter, we have a 13-13 tie, and now can Kevin Gessling get his second extra point of the game. He's waiting to see if TV's here so he can go ahead. And indeed, Gessling lines things up. Alex Carter will hold an all-important extra point here. Ball's placed down. It's kicked. It's up. It's perfect. Kevin Gessling's 2-for-2. Portland with two touchdowns here in this first quarter and with 3:02 to go. It's Portland 14 Arizona 13. We'll be right back on 750, 1029 The Game.
Arizona gets a kick return for a touchdown, early in the game. Then the Thunder respond, and then, of course, Arizona comes back again with another quick score down by the goal line with a controversial catch, a deep catch there with Dwight McClain on defense, and then the Thunder respond again. I mean, I would say that Coach Owensy has to be pretty happy, at least with the way his offense has been, considering that they've been stalling a little bit in the past couple weeks.
Short kick by Gesling, taken by Cruz. He's to the 5, he's to the 10. He breaks away, he's to the 15. He could go all the way again for the second time tonight. He does. Touchdown, Arizona Rattlers. Once again, it's number 7, A.J. Cruz. And that was just too easy.
That was too easy. And, you know, I know that certain players are asking for a hold there. I think Robert Hayes is out there not too happy.
No, he's not.
And then he was held on that play. And actually, I don't know if it would have made a difference, but Kevin Gesling, his shoulder pad was grabbed as he was trying to go for the tackle. Not sure if Gesling would have been able to make the play anyway. He didn't the first time around. But, man, you thought special teams would be to the Thunder advantage. Here in the first quarter, it's obviously been quite the opposite.
All right, so Skoscia trying the extra point to make it 20-14, Arizona. The ball's placed down. He kicks it, and it just sneaks inside the right upright. So with 2:05 to go, it is now 20-14. And we'll keep it right here, Brian. And that is a disturbing trend to see two kickoff returns in one quarter against Portland.
Well, special teams has been
7:53 to go in this first quarter. Let's see if they can regain the lead before the end of the quarter or just maintain possession moving into the second quarter of play here at the Moda Center on this Friday night. Gorgeous outside today. Had lunch along the banks of the Willamette River. It was fantastic.
Oh, well, look who's rubbing it in.
I know.
International commercial sensation Ron Callen.
Let's see. It is Lacey, and there's a penalty flag. Right at the moment Perry was about to catch the ball, there was a flag. Let's see what the call is. If it's on the defense or the offense. Let's get Reggie Smith's interpretation coming up here shortly. Big number 67 looks around, wants to talk to Mike Hohensee, so it's against Arizona.
On the defense, the rushing linebacker was moving forward prior to the snap. That's a 5-yard penalty, repeat first down.
So there's one of your arena football rules that is unique to this game. A 5-yard penalty remains first down. First and 5 for Portland. And really now, the playbook, they can go pretty deep here with only 5 yards to go for a first down. At their own 10, Kyle Rowley brings up the Thunder. Vikeon Lacey in motion, running straight forward. Back to pass, Rowley looks deep for Lacey. It's a battle down there. He tries to get the one hand out there to catch it. Knocks down one of the pads, and it looks like he was in quite a battle with the defender. And that is number 20. That is, of course, Jeremy Kellum.
Yeah, Jeremy Kellum there almost intercepted that ball.
Illegal contact, number 20 defense. Initiating contact with a receiver more than 5 yards downfield. That's a 5-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
That's a good call, but Kellum, you watch this play, and they're both up against the pads, and the ball keeps falling along the pads about 10 yards down the field. Kellum almost comes up with an interception that wouldn't have mattered, but you can't grab guys when the ball's in the air and you're not looking back.
55 seconds and counting to go in this first quarter. Portland's picked up 10 yards courtesy of two penalties on Arizona's defense. Number 73 in there for Portland, Sam Longo playing left tackle for Portland right now as Rowley has time, throws across the middle, and it's almost intercepted. That was an errant pass by Rowley, and he probably is breathing a huge sigh of relief right now.
Yeah, and Sam Longo almost lined up on the wrong side of the field. John Collins made sure center that everyone was in where they needed to be, and a great job actually by Longo on that play, picking up a block.
Looks like another penalty, or was it? Or apparently they picked up the flag and no penalty, so it's going to be second down and 10 for Portland, but the clock has stopped with 33.9 seconds to go. Now they move the clock again. Mike Hohensee up on the big screen for a moment there. Let's see what he is called with. It'll be Perez Ashford in motion, number 15 for Portland. 22 seconds to go in the quarter. Rowley fires into the crowd, and a souvenir for a young woman in the first row, just about midfield. She's pretty darn happy, getting high fives from all of her family and friends. And that makes it a third down, and that's going to be the last play of the first quarter. Portland will have... Here we go. Portland going left to right to start the second quarter. Rally back to pass at his own 10. Looks deep, and it's intercepted right into the arms of number 11. That's Brown. He's trying to get to the end zone. He's still on his feet, finally brought down by Sam Longo, but not a great start to the second quarter for the Portland Thunder. One pass and his first interception of the night, but that was not a pretty play.
No, it was not. And actually what happened on that play was Jared Perry was going over the middle and stumbled and fell. So Arkeith Brown sat back and basically Rally ended up throwing into double coverage, didn't even know it, underthrew the football, and that's how you get the interception.
14:45 to go in this first half now. Arizona with a 6-point lead, and now they've got a huge chance to increase it to 13. Let's see if the Portland Thunder defense can create problems for the quarterback for Arizona, Nick Davila. Where's number 10? He's the lefty. Reads in motion. Back to pass. Fires to the end zone. Oh, and it's almost intercepted, or was it? It was almost intercepted by Osaji Odiasi. He had one hand on it, but could not hold on.
Yeah, the ball hit that. We've talked about that last
quarter. Hit the Leshwah barrier.
Hit the upper barrier, which is incomplete. It can hit those bottom, that bottom barrier with the pads, but not the upper part.
Here's the replay. A great effort, though, by Osaji Odiasi, who couldn't quite hold on to it.
And I'm not sure what Davila was really thinking on that play. Odiasi had, I mean, he was right on him the entire time. There was no field left to work with. I'm not sure what Davila had in mind as he threw that ball. Not a smart play. He
second
got away with
and goal. Back to pass. Davila rolls to his left. Fires. And this time it's complete for a touchdown for Arizona. Odiasi almost got to this one. But nope, it's Reed for the touchdown. And Arizona takes a 26-14 lead. Kerry Reed out of Michigan State, 6'2", 205 with 13:17 to go. Arizona has their biggest lead of the night.
A couple things out of that play. First of all, Kerry Reed, just a crossing route all the way from the right side of the field to the left. But actually, there was some miscommunication. Odiasi wasn't sure where he was supposed to be on that play, which put him a step behind. But thirdly, Bryce Pila almost tipped that ball into the stands. Did get a hand on it, but not enough to slow it down.
Scotia for the extra point for Arizona. He placed up. It's kicked. It's good. 12:51 left in the first half. Arizona now with a 27-14 lead over the Portland Thunder. We'll take a break and continue live.
You know, maybe less than average like myself, you're going to go out there and have a good time.
Exactly, and that's the whole idea about golf, you know.
So some of the players were out there.
A lot of them, since it's out not too far from the practice facilities on the east side, they get out there. And here's the kickoff by Arizona. Portland going left to right. Dwayne Brooks takes it off the net. He gets to the end zone, to the five. He breaks away from a tackle, but there's a penalty flag, and he's brought down by Cruz at about the three-yard line. Let's see where they mark it, but there is a penalty, and this could be a hold against Portland. Reggie Smith, the white hat tonight.
If there's a penalty on a kick return, it's usually not for the receiving
team. Return, holding, number 20, the receiving team. Penalty's after this, the goal.
So they're calling it against Bryce Pila. And so Portland will get the ball. Kyle Rally, and you want to know, you know, you think, can he just put that INT out of his mind and get back on a positive vibe? Because he played so well until that moment.
Yeah, and he's, you know, he's such a tough guy mentally. You know, when he was replaced by Darren Thomas, you know, he didn't back down when he had to come back in and play. You know, he's just that type of player. So I don't expect him to be shaken by this at all. But you have to take care of the football here. There's a little bit of miscommunication. There is Perez Ashford comes in late.
First down and 10 for Portland, and the play clock was going down to zero, so Portland had to call a timeout.
And I don't believe they actually called it.
Or is it a delay of game?
That was the smart thing to do,
take the penalty because your ball's already at the one, so now it's at about the 4-inch line.
And that was smart of, you know, Rally probably could have rushed that play through, but, you know, Ashford was late getting onto the field. Why push it? Why not just let it expire? You're already, you know, pushed up against the goal line. It doesn't make any sense. You got to execute here down when you're so deep in your own territory.
11:50 to go in this first half. The three-time defending Arena Bowl champs, Arizona 27, Portland 14. And a couple of mistakes on special teams and an interception have hurt Portland tonight. Rally in his own end zone. Fires over to the left-hand side, and it's overthrown. The intended receiver was Jared Perry. He was covered pretty closely by Marquise Floyd, so Rally just had to get rid of it and throw it in the stands.
Yeah, and Rally on that play, well, not only was the coverage, you know, good, Rally was under pressure in the end zone, and you can't take a sack there. You got to get rid of
it. You cannot take a sack in the end zone because that means 2 points, of course, for your opponent. So I guess a smart play, but he's got to get better protection by the offensive line of Portland, which includes right now John Collins at center. Longo will be on the right-hand side, and number 50, Jerome McCullough, 6'7", 300 on the left-hand side. Quick pass out to the left-hand flat to Perry. He gets enough for a first down out to about the 13-yard line before Kellum pushes him out of bounds.
How big was that? Just to get out of the shadow of your own end zone, push the ball downfield, move the sticks. Him and Perry have been not on the same page in this game so far. There have been some frustration between Rowley and Perry. I think that was important. They actually gave each other a high five after that play.
All right, so with 10:30 to go, Portland down 13. You know, they get the ball first at the start of the third quarter. So if they can get to within a touchdown and then hold Arizona out, they've got a great chance tonight here at the Moda Center. Brooks in motion. Now it's a nice pass, but it's deflected. A good job by Cruz. Perry was wide open in Arizona territory, but Cruz just got a little bit on that football to deflect it away from Perry.
Yeah, a great job there by Cruz, kind of just sitting back in coverage in the zone and gets enough of his hand, like Bryce Pila did on that touchdown pass. Unfortunately, Pila didn't quite get his mitts on enough of that ball, but a good job defensively. This is what the Rattlers do. They like to disrupt things. Not always going to force a turnover, but they're going to disrupt, you know, the flow of your offense with plays like that.
Second down and 10 for Portland. Their own 14-yard line. 9:45 to go, first half. Perry in motion. Rally back to pass. Under pressure, he's down. He is sacked by the Arizona defensive line at the 4-yard line. And it looks like his big number 90, Mike McAdoo, out of North Carolina. And Brian's going to be doing some research to find out.
He is no relation to Bob McAdoo. I did the research.
You did the research.
Yes, I did not see anything where he is related. And he is built well, 6'7", 250.
He could play hoops.
And yes, he could. And he's a skinny guy as well. And he came around the edge in a hurry. Jerome McCullough just couldn't handle him on that play. And the offensive line has done a nice job all game. But that time, Rally, on his blind side, had no chance.
Kyle Rally under center, third down and 17. He's hit as he throws. It's deep. He tries to hit Ashford, but he is down. And it looks like Kyle Rally was hit hard. And he might be shaken up. His helmet is off as he gets up, but I'm not sure if he's okay. They're going to have to take a look at him right now. That'll be a fourth down. Is there a penalty?
Foul. Illegal hands to the face. Number 50 in the offense. That penalty declined. Fourth down.
So it's against McCullough, and so it is a fourth down. Looks like Rally's okay.
Well, and Rally
puts the helmet back on, but he was hit hard. You can see he was down in the end zone on his back, helmet off.
He was, and, you know, Jared Perry with a really nice double move to get open, but Rally, I mean, he was hit. I'm surprised the ball was overthrown.
Yeah.
You know, Rally just didn't really have a chance to set his feet and make the throw he needed to there.
Well, they need to get to midfield, or else they're going to give up the ball to Arizona with 8:30 to go in this first half, and there is a whistle, and I think Perry might have been offside. He was the wide receiver in motion.
Start offense. Number 73, penalties after this to go. It remains fourth down.
No, it looks like it's on Sam Longo, the offensive lineman. And it looks like because of the pressure, the offensive lineman a little bit with happy feet trying to get moving as early as they can. In that case, Longo moved a little too early.
I mean, you have McAdoo on that line, 6'7", 250. Tyree Glasper, 6'3", 270. I mean, we're talking about some pretty big players. Cliff Duke, 6'4", 300 pounds almost.
And they all have pretty good speed as well. So now it's Perry in motion on this fourth down. And Rally, did he call a timeout? Oh, it is a delay of game. Once again, the game clock.
It's a yard and a half penalty. I know the crowd isn't too happy with all the penalties, but once again, you're going to need these timeouts late in the quarter if you want to try to gain the advantage back. right. score and then get the ball back. I mean, that's really how you get back into this game if you're not able to stop the Rattlers defensively. So a smart move by Riley there to just, I mean, save the timeout. You're going to lose a yard and a half yard. Is that going to make a difference here on fourth and long?
But you know what? The Arizona defense can just tee off on, yep. on Riley here. It's fourth and 22. He's got to go back into the end zone and go deep. He throws it high in the air. Brooks is down there, and Brooks tries to get there, but he is shielded from the ball by the defender, and the crowd wants pass interference, but there's no flag.
Yeah, and I don't think that was PI on that play, as it looks like.
The defender is still down. That's number 19, Marquise Floyd, the DB out of West Georgia.
And, you know, I mean, the thing is Brooks went to the inside. That throw was to the outside. He can't get into Floyd's space. Floyd had every right to be running alongside him.
Third down and goal at the Portland half-yard line. 27-14 Rattlers with 6:10 to go in this first half. Portland, this would be huge if they could hold them out once more. Let's see. Reed's in motion. Davila hands off to Benson, and he waltzes into the end zone around the right end for another touchdown for Arizona. So 5:55 to go. It's now 33-14 Rattlers. Couple of special teams issues for Portland. A big interception and the inability to convert on fourth downs cost him in this first half.
Yeah, and obviously the Thunder were expecting maybe another run up the middle there because, you know, Benson found his, easy seam up the middle. No one was near him. Closest yeah. player was Casey.
Well, right around the right end
away.
There, yeah. So here's the extra point attempt by Fabrizio Scascia. 5:23 to go. Scascia, ball's placed down. He kicks it. Perfect. So with 5:17 to go, it is 34-14 and a little battle for the football in the stands. Don't forget, June the 21st, it'll be Star Wars night and Father's Day celebration right here at the Moda Center. And a key game next weekend, Spokane coming to town. And let's see what Spokane's up to right now, their battle against the Las Vegas Outlaws. Second quarter in Spokane. The Shock trail 35-14.
Wow, the Outlaws, I mean, talk about a team coming out of the gate. They get a win to start the year. They beat the Rattlers. It's not easy for an expansion team.
No.
A lot of moving parts, not only on the field, but front office, coaching staff, ownership, all those things. Yet you see a team that's come in and obviously, at the very least, has been competitive night in, night out. And the Shock, you know, a franchise with a lot of history, not able to get things going here, moving in the right direction, Ron. They won a couple of straight games, but, you know, you feel like the Thunder here have a definite chance to not only move past them, but, you know, fight with the Outlaws as well there for that third playoff spot in their conference.
5:17 to go in this first half. Scotch is going to kick off to Dwayne Brooks, and maybe this is the time Dwayne can light it up for Portland on the kickoff special teams return unit. He takes it off the net 5 yards deep in the end zone. He gets to the 5, the 10, the 15. There's a penalty flag. He's going to go all the way, but they threw the penalty flag. Brooks is in for a potential Portland Thunder touchdown, but it is a hold against Portland. And we do have an injured Arizona Rattler on the turf. Here's Reggie Smith.
Very turn, holding, number 20 of the receiving team. Kelly's after this to the goal, first down.
That's twice on Pila.
So Pila, let's see if we can check it on the replay, see if it is. But
by the way, I believe that starter Chase the Aider there that is down.
He's up on his knees, but he's unable to get up any further.
Boy, and what I see there is hands inside, no definite grab. Let's watch this again. Boy, that's
a close one. There's no blatant call by Pila, no. But tough break for Dwayne Brooks. That would have been his seventh kickoff return six.
That's tough.
That is kind of a ticky-tack call.
To say the least, his hands were inside. There was no grab of the jersey. I'm not sure what the official saw there. I'm assuming it was the motion and I'm not sure who that was. I want to say it was Marcus Smith on special teams.
And it was a bad call.
It was a bad call.
You can hear the fans here not happy. The boo birds have come out on the officials, the guys in the striped shirts, and justifiably so. I mean, Here is the premier kickoff returner in the league, breaking one for a touchdown.
The Zebras have not been friendly to the Thunder the past couple weeks. Let's put it that way.
Really, the entire season, they haven't got a lot of breaks. But it is a first down, 34-14 Arizona, 4:48 to go. Portland first and 10 at their own 9. Quick pass to the right flat to Perry, who's tied up immediately by number 18, Marquise Floyd. And that's a pickup of maybe a yard.
I'd like to see Riley look over the middle a bit more there. Ashford was open about 10 yards down the field.
The safe pass to the flat now, yep. Down 20 points with 4:23 to go in the first half. You want to see them attack, maybe go vertical.
I'd like to see that a little bit more downfield here.
Let's see what happens on this second and 9. Perry in motion, back to pass rally. He gets rid of it, floats it into the stands, and a catch by one of the Portland Thunder fans. In fact, I think his girlfriend, wife, friend, has already picked up a football, so it's a plethora. Yeah, it's
a plethora of footballs.
Plethora of football. So there you have it here. Great catch, but not the outcome that Portland fans want. It's now a third and 9.
I believe one of the girls in the group, the younger girls, is part of the dance team that was their pregame.
The pregame dance team from one of the local high schools. So congratulations to them. Let's see if Portland can get moving offensively now. It is Perry in motion. Rally back to pass. Has time. Fires across the middle. It's intercepted again. Kellum this time as Rally goes down. Interception number 2. And now you say to yourself, well, how long before we see number 18, Alex Carter?
Yeah, and that's definitely an issue. But right now protection is a big issue. Rally was hammered on that play from two different directions. I'm surprised he was able to get up after that. He was hit high, he was hit low, and, you know, when you have that constant pressure on you, Ron, it just gets in your head.
Yes,
you're going to start to overthrow, underthrow, you're going to rush passes, you're not going to let the routes develop, and you're going to see plays like that.
Good points by Brian Perkins here regarding Kyle Rally. It's Arizona ball, Davila back to pass at midfield. Penalty flag down as he tries to get to Cruz in the end zone, but what a great defensive play by Osaji Odiasi to bat that ball away from Cruz.
Some of the fans are doing the Dikembe Mutombo, not in my house, wag. We'll see who the penalty's on.
Here's Reggie.
Table formation defense. The linebacker was moving forward at the snap. That's a 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Refs are watching that one tonight, Ron. They've called one on each team so far tonight.
And Bryce Pila, that's 3 penalties on him tonight. And I know he's not thrilled with that.
No, especially, I mean, he's one of the top players at his position in the league. And he's talking with the ref right now.
So far in this game, 7 penalties on Portland for 28 yards, only 2 penalties on Arizona for 10 yards.
And one of those penalties, while the yardage isn't huge, prevented a touchdown.
Davila at midfield, fires across the middle, and a one-handed catch by Windsor for a touchdown. He kind of brought up the left arm, batted it down, and caught it. And so with 2:30 to go in this first half, Arizona has 40 points, Portland with 14. And, of course, 2 of those touchdowns courtesy of kickoff return.
And you know what? Davila is, you know, there was pressure on that play. He has done a good job, and we talked before the game about pressure, standing in the pocket, he didn't take a hit on that play, but just showing the composure to get to his playmaker, Rod Windsor, a name surprisingly we haven't called too much in this game.
2 minutes to go in the first half. Scotia preparing for another extra point for Arizona. It's placed down, it kicked, it's up. It is good. 1:53 to go in the first half. Arizona, 41. Portland, 14. And I'll tell you what, it's been a clinic put on by Arizona so far tonight, and they are the champions of this league, the three-time defending champions, Brian.
Yeah.
And you've got to say, well, they're running on all cylinders tonight.
Check this out, Ron. Nick Davila has 3 completions tonight, 4 pass attempts, and this team has 41 points.
Wow.
I mean, that's your 3-time defending champions right there.
Pretty efficient.
I would say so. And I mean, the bigger story really in the end is that the Thunder have not been able to keep up. The Rattlers are going to score. Really, it comes down to timing. Can you be the last to score and first to score to start the second half? Ron, you're going to give yourself a chance at the end of the game, even if you can't get a stop. But 2 interceptions, you can't make those types of mistakes. A holding penalty, I know it was a bogus one, but regardless, a holding penalty that prevents a kickoff return for a touchdown. Those types of plays are going to lose you games against the best team in the league, or arguably.
And, you know, stats can be so misleading. I mean, time of possession, Portland 17-16, Arizona 10-07. And total plays, Portland with 22 offensive plays. Arizona's only had 9 offensive plays in this first half.
Yeah, I mean, it's a big difference, but maybe Dwayne Brooks can do something special here.
Gets it off the net, 6 yards deep to the goal line. Breaks a tackle to the 5, the 10, the 15, the 20, the 25, the 20. He's going to go all the way. Dwayne Brooks, another touchdown on a kickoff return. And that's what the fans have come to see here tonight. And he did not disappoint. Let me look around. No penalty flags. Touchdown, Portland Thunder is now 41-20.
And I believe Dwayne Brooks did a beast mode backward jump into the end zone, if you know what I'm talking about.
I saw that.
To end that play. And you know what? Gosh darn it, he's earned it, Ron. 2 kickoff returns for a touchdown in this game. Of course, only one is counted. You know,
he breaks a tackle, cruises tackle, and then he's untouched, I think, the rest of the way. It may be there was somebody touched him at the 15, but he goes into the end zone. Yes, he did an exact copy of the beast mode, grabbing you-know-what and getting into the end zone. And a lot of time left for Portland to make a comeback. Will they try some chicanery here with a potential onside kick, or will Kevin Gessle go deep? We'll see what he is going to do. Looks like he's going to kick it deep, but you never know. In arena football.
Rattlers are ready for an outside kick.
And he does. He pooches it. It's up for grabs, and it's taken by number 15, Reed, who is tackled at the 19-yard line. So a good attempt by Gessling, but the Portland Thunder players couldn't get to that ball before number 15, Kerry Reed, the Michigan State Spartan, who will see the Ducks September the 12th in East Lansing. That should be one heck of a game, the rematch of the game last year in Eugene.
Of course, Darren Thomas here of the Thunder will be keeping an eye out on that one,
No doubt about that. And on that same day, the Beavers will play in Ann Arbor against Michigan on that September the 12th. Here we go. It's 1st and 10 at the 19-yard line, 53 seconds to go. Davila throws to the left flat, finds Cruz at the 15. He gets to about the 11. Bryce Pila trying to knock the ball out of his hands along with Marquise Jackson, but Cruz hangs on to it. And he's in a little bit of a discussion with Bryce Pila.
And Marquise Jackson. And Jackson actually gave him a little shove there. I'm glad the refs let that one go. Not a big deal. It didn't escalate anything. Just move on. Nothing to see here.
9-yard pickup. 2nd down and 1 at the 11. Will Arizona try to get into the end zone? Well, they have to call a timeout. They've got 2 timeouts. 30 seconds to go, and now there is a stoppage in play with 5 seconds left on the play clock. And I'm not sure, there was some confusion. Now,
the play clock was at 5 seconds, I believe. Maybe it ran a little early.
So here we go. 22 seconds left in the half. Davila was going to pitch out to Benson. Benson to the 10, to the 5, and he downs it at the 1-yard line. He could have gone in for the score. But Arizona wants to work more clock, and at the 1-yard line, I guarantee you with 9.1 seconds to go, we have a penalty
Their second charge timeout of the half, a 30-second timeout.
So it's a timeout for Arizona, but there's something else that happened after the play, and we're going to find out just a second.
Score swing there from the Thunder one way or another.
Arizona has one more timeout. Portland has all three of theirs. It's Davila. He's going to pass it. Fires to the end zone. It's incomplete. The ball was intended for Windsor. Nice job by Matt Pierce there to create some issues. And so with 4.6 seconds to go, it's going to be a second down and about a yard, yard and a half to go. But
you
not a lot of time left. Now, Arizona's got to make a decision.
Maybe.
Do they run it in now? They do have one timeout. But
you have one timeout, but, man, if you get stuffed on the one-yard line, it's going to take more than 4 seconds to get him down, whistles to blow, all that jazz. You're probably going to see a couple of quick passes. Maybe not, though, if they have faith in the run game up the middle.
Reads in motion. Davila will pass it. Fires to the end zone, and it's complete. The number 15, Kerry Reed, as you hear the game clock go down to zero, 47-21, as Pierce is going into kind of a conversation with Benson that I'm sure there was things said we can't say on the radio. But I'll tell you what, impressive first half by Arizona to come away with 47, perhaps 48 points. And Portland with 21. Of course, we'll have highlights and all sorts of good stuff at halftime for you here on 750-1029 the game. Scotia will try to make it 48 points in this first half for Arizona. The ball is placed down. It's kicked. It's up. And it is good. And that's the end of the first half. Indeed, an impressive first half for Arizona, playing like defending champions.
They are, and on pace for 96 points, I would say, the coaching staff there.
What time do you want to be out?
Well, they're 90 seconds. We'll go really quick here.
How long are the breaks? Like 140?
90 seconds.
Okay.
So, hey, how much time, Dave? Okay. To 21, the Portland Thunder trail the Arizona Rattlers, three-time defending champions, I guess I should preface that with. Give
yes,
them the proper
should.
Respect. Ron Callen calling the game. Ron, it just seemed like perfection almost from the Rattlers in every part of the game.
Well, you look at the stats. You look at the percentage of their quarterback. You look at what happened as far as penalties go.
Yeah.
And it's been all Arizona. And Portland has had some great moments. They got off to the great start.
Yep.
You know, they had the lead. They were going toe-to-toe, and then kickoff returns hurt them, but two critical interceptions on Kyle Rowley really just handed the momentum to Arizona.
Yeah, and we could be talking about a 41-28 lead right now, but that, we'll say, questionable call by the officials ended up leading to that Kyle Rowley second interception, which
yes.
led to subsequently that Rattlers score. Who knows how things end up if that play goes differently, but it didn't, and the Thunder have to live with that going forward here. But real quick before the break, I mean, what do you need to see to mount a comeback? Obviously, onside kick recovery, a score here, an onside kick recovery, and some sort of turnover minimum to get you back in this game.
Absolutely. You're right on the money. And What I want to see them do is get the, you know, whether or not Dwayne Brooks runs one back for a touchdown to begin the second half, I want to see the offense. I want to see the offense go down and score quickly. You know,
yeah.
Three or four plays, let's get a quick score. And then, like you say, maybe an onside kick, get the ball back, and
yeah.
they'll be right back in this game.
Yeah, they will. And, you know, it's not over till it's over. And the Thunder have shown a lot of heart, Ron, late in these games. So, I mean, that's
absolutely
it's never over, especially with 30 minutes to go in this game. All right, second half is going to come your way here in just a few minutes, 48-21. Ron Callan going to have the call for your second half action. You're listening to 750 and 102.9 The Game. I'll be right back.
For Blueprint Arts and Theater Ensemble. That'll be June the 20th. And always great to see the Portland Thunder involve themselves in the community. Dwayne Brooks will be potentially receiving the kickoff from Arizona. We start this third quarter. Portland will be going from our left to our right. As you look at your car radio or your laptop, here's the kickoff by Skasha. It's going to go off the net. And it's out of bounds. It'll be a touchback, and Portland will get the ball first down. No chance for Dwayne Brooks there, Brian. Too bad for the fans.
Yeah, and that's something that, you know, the Rattlers have actually done a good job. They haven't had to kick it out of bounds. We've got a couple right up the middle there, and Dwayne hasn't had an opportunity, and that's really the best weapon you have right now.
All right, here comes Portland. We have a new quarterback. Alex Carter will start the third quarter for Mike Hohensey, as Kyle Rowley has the helmet off at the Portland bench. So we get a chance to see what Alex Carter can do, see if he can spark Portland's offense as we begin the third quarter. First and 10 for Portland at their own 5-yard line. Perry in motion. Carter quickly gets it to Perry at about the 11-yard line. He tries to break a tackle, gets away from Kellum, but is pushed out of bounds. And let's say pickup of about 8 for Portland on that play.
And this was the storyline that we talked about pregame, Ron, was, you know, things get out of hand. If there's a couple of turnovers, could we see a change of quarterback? And that's exactly what Coach Hohensey has done here. You know, Kyle Rowley still out there on the bench, right up against the pads, watching all the action though.
Here we go, number 18, Carter, of course, out of Western Michigan. Back to pass, two-step drop, quick pass to Perry. It's enough for a first down at about the 18-yard line. At their own 18, but two quick passes. You want to get warmed up. You want to get comfortable. And so that's what Alex Carter's doing right now.
Yeah, we were talking about taking shots down the field, but, you know, you got to give him some time here to come in the game and just, you know, loosen up the arm a little bit. You know, it's almost like a pitcher, right? You just you got to give him a couple of shots here to get him in rhythm on the line, you know, in the game as a quarterback. So obviously that's what they're trying to do here early on.
His third game on the Portland roster, his second time playing quarterback. Back to pass. He goes deep now for Brooks, and it's almost intercepted by Kellum. He overthrew Dwayne Brooks a little bit. Whether Dwayne broke off that pattern a little early or not, they were not in sync on that potential connection.
Yeah, they definitely were not on that play. And, you know, Brooks is a smaller guy. You know, he's not 6'4". He's not a Bakian Lacy, who, by the way, has been virtually a non-factor in this game early on for the Thunder. But, you know, one way or another, with Brooks, it's a tighter window. You got to get to him.
Perry will be in motion for Portland. Second down and 10 on their own 19-yard line. Early third quarter action. Carter across the middle finds a wide open. Jared Perry at the 15-yard line of Arizona. He fights his way down to the 13. Nice pass, nice catch, nice yardage after the catch. And it's a first down for Portland, now officially the 14-yard line.
Yeah, and the 14-yard line, and Alex Carter there, nice job. Just and Perry, by the way, finding a spot right in the middle of that zone to come down with that football, and this is a drive that the Thunder desperately needed to start the second half.
48-21 Arizona, and here come the Thunder with a first down. It'll be Perry in motion. Carter with 4 seconds on the play clock. Back to pass, five-step drop, throws it toward the end zone. It's tipped and incomplete, and it was a pass intended for Jared Perry. And the defender, slow getting up, he tipped the pass, and that's number 11, Arkeith Brown out of Texas A&M.
Yeah, and you know what's interesting about that is I think if Perry would have followed that play all the way through, he might have had a chance to come down with that ball. Remember, when the ball hits the pads, it is still live, and maybe that was going to be out of his reach one way or another, but, man, Brown took a shot, didn't he, against those pads trying to make that play.
Dwayne Brooks comes out of the game. Perez Ashford replaces him at wide receiver. He's in the right slot. Lacy's split wide to the right. Perry in motion on the left side. Carter throws it right into the arms of number 19, who laterals it to Kellum. And there's a penalty flag. Marquise Floyd with the interception. He may have lateraled that ball forward, which is illegal.
Boy, that's just bizarre that you're going to try to lateral it to your teammate.
Well, you've got a 27-point lead. And bottom line is we'll get a call here from Reggie Smith, the lead official on this crew.
I think they're trying to decide whether or not it indeed was a forward pass. I'm not sure what difference it's going to make, a yard maybe.
Here's Smith.
Illegal forward, perhaps an illegal forward pass. On the offense, the ball was thrown forward. That penalty tapped it into the goal. The ball be placed on the 2-yard line, first down.
Going here.
Yep.
After the interception, it's a first down and 10. For Arizona, they are at their own 2-yard line. They're going right to left as we're looking at the field here at the Moda Center. Nice crowd on hand tonight. Haven't seen an attendance figure yet. But Davila deep in the end zone fires. It's complete to Windsor at about the 14-yard line, but it is enough for a Arizona first down.
Yeah, and you know, Windsor has been in this league for a long time. He and Davila played together for a while. They know what's what to expect, but another penalty on the Thunder. That's an illegal hands to the face for that 10-yard penalty there. And, boy, the coaching staff is not happy with Reggie and his crew tonight. And the penalty discrepancy is wide. And there have been some bad calls, Ron, but at the same time, I mean, this is what championship teams do is they don't, you know, they're not heavily penalized.
Well, you look at the penalty differential, it's the 10th penalty on Portland. Only 3 on Arizona so far tonight.
Yeah, and the Rattlers are that type of team, but look at where this moves the ball now, Ron. You go from the
right to midfield.
Yep.
So it's a big pickup. And Arizona now at the 25-yard line, right at midfield, with a first down and 10. Windsor in motion. Davila back to pass, forced out of the pocket, fires across the middle. It's complete to Reed. Reed breaks one tackle. Breaks the Matt Pierce's tackle, but Casey Obi says, you're going nowhere else.
Yeah.
And he picks up about 8 yards.
Casey Obi is a bad man. He is a very big guy, a very strong guy, and when he gets his arms around you, you're not getting much more forward progress. Let's put it that way. Nice tackle from him.
Reggie Smith, by the way, the official, is from Detroit, Michigan. So a long way from home for the lead official here tonight, who received quite a few boos from the crowd, especially on the Bryce Pila hole.
I would say he's received it about 10 times.
Yeah, not the boos, but ZE either. It's back to pass. Davila looks, fires, completes it to Windsor. Windsor, I think, has enough forward progress for a first down, and he does to the 14. So Arizona with 9:45 to go in this third quarter, with a comfortable 27-point lead over Portland, continues to move the ball.
You have to respect this play calling by the Rattlers. You know, not always necessarily going for the deep ball, but just wanting to move the chains, keep the drive going. Davila makes the right decisions there. Just another quick comeback route. They knew they needed 4 yards for the first down, and they got it. That's Arizona Rattlers football.
Davila 8-for-10 on the night. And here is this next play, first down and 10 at the 14. He picks up another 6 yards with a pass to Reed. This one will be inside the 10-yard line at the Portland 8.
And it's soft coverage for the Portland Thunder. And,
make it the 9.
You know, with this soft coverage, Ron, this is what they're going to do. They're going to take what the defense is giving them. They're in no rush. 9 minutes to go in the third quarter. They're up 27 points. You know, why push things here if you're the Rattlers? Just take what the defense is giving you.
And what Portland's defense needs is a stop.
Yes.
They want to get some confidence. They want to get the momentum switch. They want to give the fans something to cheer about. Let's see if they can do it. It's second down and 5 at the Portland 9. Reed in motion. The lefty, Davila, fires through the end zone, and it is complete to Reed. 6 points, Arizona. as Odiasi could not. He tried to deflect that ball out of Reed's hands, couldn't get it done. And the bottom line, as Matt Pierce shows his frustration with a little trash talking, but Arizona, all they have to do is say, well, look at the score.
Yeah, and, you know, that's a tough way to start the second half for the Thunder. And a piece of Kerry Reed's clothing came off. I'm not sure what it was. A sock? Now it's just thrown on the Emirates International sign there on the turf. I'm not sure exactly what it was.
Yeah, I saw it. It was either some kind of a pad or a towel, maybe. As Scotia comes in to attempt the extra point, Warriors number 17. The snap, placed down, kicked, and it's good. Timeout on the turf. 7:48 to go in this third quarter. It is 55-21 Arizona. We'll be right back on 750-1029 the game. And give these fans here at the Motor Center something to cheer about. Scotia is going to kick off. He's a right-footed kicker. Don't forget, June the 21st, back here at the Motor Center in 9 days. It'll be the Spokane Shock who are losing tonight to Las Vegas. Here's the kickoff. It's high. Will it hit the net? Yes, it hit the net. It's right to Brooks, but it was the net that's between the uprights.
5 yards. Touchback, first down.
It is a touchback.
Yeah, that slack net in the back, if it hits that, it can hit. It's bizarre, though, because sometimes the refs, it hits the bottom pole there and bounces back.
Yes.
They'll allow that, but it can't hit the slack net only and fall into your hands. That is out of bounds. Not an out of bounds on the 20-yard line. That is basically just out of the end zone.
Your basic touchback. So it'll be first and 10 for Portland at the 5. Alex Carter back in a quarterback, looking at his left wrist. This is just his second game in the quarterback spot for Portland. Now, he played last week, but only as a holder. So this is game 3 as a Portland Thunder player. Game 2 as the quarterback who's coming for the starter, Kyle Rowley. Quick pass out to the right flat to Dwayne Brooks. Brooks is pounded up against the sideboards. It looks like one of the players for Arizona is not getting up. Don't quite see who it is yet.
I think that's Arkeith Brown.
It is Arkeith Brown, who looks like he's okay. He's limping a little bit.
Boy, I'll tell you what, one thing that we're not seeing out on the field is McKeon Lacy. He hasn't been out for a couple of possessions here.
So perhaps...
I'm not seeing him on the sidelines either.
At some point, maybe during our next break, you can go run over to Rob Belke, who is the media relations director for the Portland Thunder, and find out what's going on with him. As Ashford... in motion, Carter has to get rid of it. He goes down, and looks like Brooks had a chance to break away for 6, but they're going to say he was out of bounds. Looks like the Portland Thunder do have enough for a first down. Floyd on the tackle for Arizona.
And, you know, if there's any contact at all while you're up against the pads, or contact that forces you into the pads, you are not going to be able to move forward. It's basically like stepping out of bounds. So that was the call there. I mean, he was able to bounce back inside and, you know, had a chance to go to the end zone. But obviously, with that play, he's going to be out of bounds. Good call by the official.
Carter brings up Portland. 1 second to go on the play clock, and he's going to keep it. He runs to the 15, the 20, the 25. So Carter, close to a first down. It is a first down. Nifty footwork by Alex Carter there.
When we had him on Talking Thunder a few weeks ago, Ron, we talked with him about that because he's a guy that's not exactly fleet of foot necessarily, but was able to rush the ball a bit in college. And he said, you know, it's not my first option. It's not my second option. But if things break down, yeah, I'm willing to use my feet. And that's the first time in a Thunder uniform we've seen him do just that.
Talking Thunder, by the way, every Tuesday night at 7 o'clock right here on 750-1029 the game. First and 10 for Portland at the Arizona 22-yard line. Carter back to pass. Steps up in the pocket. He's going to keep it to the 20, the 15. He gets... knocked out of bounds rather rudely by Arkeith Brown at about the 9-yard line, but Alex Carter showing he's got pretty good speed.
Yeah, that's twice now he's been able to step up in the pocket. There's no one in front of him, and he just outruns Arkeith Brown to move the sticks. Now, last time they were in this territory, of course, we saw an interception. Can Carter take care of the ball here? And no dirty play there by Brown, just a hard push into the pads.
It was a hard push. But it was a fair push. You're right.
I mean, it's the pads. So I think, you know, these guys, there's a lot of give there.
4:30 to go in this third quarter. Portland threatened. Ashford in motion. And Carter gets rid of it as he's brought down. And guess who is the intended receiver? McKeon Lacy. So Lacey back in the game. So you don't need to go talk to Rob now because he's okay.
Yes, he is. And that was a story in the first half, Ron. He did not have, I think he had one reception in the first half, and I can double check on that stat, but was ineffective. And this is a guy that when Jamar Howard went down with injury, he was really able to come in and have an impact. And yeah, so far just 8 yards and 1 8-yard reception for McKeon Lacey.
7 receptions for Jared Perry for 90 yards. That leads Portland's offense tonight as Ashford goes in motion. 2nd and 9 at the 9. Carter steps up in the pocket. There's a penalty flag as he throws toward the end zone toward Perry. The ball goes into the stands incomplete, but there is a penalty on the play. Is it holding? Is it illegal defense? Let's find out. It's holding against Portland. Here's Reggie Smith with the official call.
Holding, offense number 79. 10-yard penalty. Second down.
John Collins, the Ivy League product.
The kid out of Harvard. And, of course, Alex Carter played his college football in Western Michigan.
What's odd about that call by Reggie is that John Collins was bull rushed. He was knocked over. Maybe he prevented him from getting up. That's the only holding that I saw in that play.
2nd down and goal at the 19-yard line. So Portland with 3 more chances to get it into the end zone here. They can't get a first down. Perry in motion. Carter throws toward the end zone. Perry's there. Touchdown, Portland Thunder. Jared Perry in the right corner of the end zone. He had a pretty brutal meeting with the sideboard, but he held on, and it's now 55-27.
He did, and an extra glare towards the Rattlers bench as he makes that catch. And Jared Perry has been the shining star in this game tonight, Ron. His 3rd touchdown reception.
No doubt about that. A good performance by Jared Perry. Kevin Gessling, the lefty out of Fresno State, will attempt the extra point. Carter will hold. Portland down 55-27. Gessling's ready to go. The ball snapped, placed down, kicked. It's up, and it's good. 2:32 to go in this 3rd quarter. Portland gets on the board in this quarter. It's Arizona 55, Portland 28. We'll be right back on 750-1029 the game.
Let's hear it, fans. What is it?
For the defense to step up with Arizona backed up against their own end zone. 1st down and 10 at their own 2. Let's see what Davila does. He's going to go for all the money. Reed's down there. He drops the ball. Pierce fell down, and it was just all there for Reed to catch it to score, and he couldn't hang on.
Yeah, there's nothing else to say. It was just a go route. Pierce falls down. Has something to say to Reed afterwards. That's the type of thing you look at film after this game and everyone's going to clown him in the film room.
I mean, Pierce right falls down. And
right, as he tries to bring it in, Reed, it looks like it just bounces off of his pads awkwardly, and he's beating himself up a little bit for that one.
And now we have a penalty flag before the play even is run. The back judge with a delay of game against Arizona, and that'll be half the distance to the goal. Here's Reggie Smith.
Delay of game, offense. Penalty after this goal, 2nd down.
He just heard me say that. He repeated what I said.
He did. Copycat.
So it's now, the ball is really at about that inside the 1 now. great opportunity for this defense to either pick up two
yep.
or create some kind of a turnover. Let's see what happens. Davila with Windsor in motion. Quick pass to the right-hand side, and it is incomplete. Pretty good defense by number 21, Dwight McLean. So that makes it third down and 11 for Arizona.
McLean was part of that secondary that was pretty nasty for the Thunder last season. Him, Varmasoni, one of the better defensive backs in the league, and Eric Crocker as well.
Right.
A very dangerous secondary, and McLean is back for the Thunder. Good to see.
48 seconds to go in this third quarter. The clock continues to roll. Arizona taking their time, working the clock a little bit. Davila back in the end zone, fires, and the ball, I think it might have been partially deflected by, it could have been Marquise Jackson, it could have been Robert Hayes who deflected that ball. It could have been Odiasi. Let's see what we can see it on the replay. That could be the last play
Davila,
of the third quarter.
Davila was under tremendous pressure. He was at the back of the end zone, was about to get sacked, had to get rid of that football. And you're right, someone got their hand on it, but I don't know if it had a chance anyway. Tight coverage. And you're right, I don't think that they're going to.
4 seconds to go. It looks like Davila will just wait. And we'll have that big fourth down play when we come back, when we begin the fourth quarter. We're 3/4 of the way through this one. Arizona with a 55-28 lead over Portland. And we'll be right back on 750 1029 The Game. But they dial up. Davila back in the end zone near that back wall, gets rid of it, and it's complete. I think he's got enough for the first down. Yes, indeed.
Yeah,
out to the
14-yard
line. Windsor with the reception. A nice play by Davila because he was just about up against that back wall and barely got rid of it in time.
Yeah, and that was forward progress. You know, he was tackled behind the sticks, but you're going to give him that. And what a big play. And that's what championship football teams do, is big plays. Davila, the pocket is collapsing in the back of the end zone. He gets the ball off just in time. His receiver gets just enough separation and comes away with the catch.
14:22 to go in this one. First down and 10 at their own 14. A little screen pass out to Benson. He gets to the 20. He's to the 25, and he's brought down inside Portland territory by Bryce Pila, by Robert Hayes, by Casey Obi. He's a big guy to bring down.
He is, and Marquise Jackson was actually kind of out on the coverage, hesitated, went back towards Davila, almost got his hand on that football, but nice touch from Davila to get that into Benson's hands.
Well, Davila's just had a real solid evening. He's 12 of 17, 135 yards, 4 touchdowns. Benson has 6 carries for 16 yards, and he's got 1 reception for 14. Here's Davila. He hands it off to Benson again. He gets the ball down to the 14-yard line. A pickup of about 7 yards. So Benson brought down by Hayes and Pila and Matt Pearson there as well.
Yeah, and right now it's just about killing clock and, you know, trying to get out of here uninjured if you're the Rattlers. And, of course, the Thunder trying to force a turnover. Maybe get something happening here, but boy, what a weapon you have in Mykel Benson, right? One of the top rushers in the league, one of 4 players with double-digit rushing touchdowns, a smart player, takes the knee at the 1-yard line, so they only get the ball to end the half. I mean, just a great player for them.
Davila, the lefty, throws it over to the left flat. It gets to Windsor. Windsor is brought down at about the 4-yard line, almost got into the end zone, but was forced out by, I believe, Pila was over there, along with number 21, McLean.
Yeah, Dwight McLean, welcome back. He's had an interesting game tonight. You know, the Thunder defense. Once again, the score, 55 points. I don't think that necessarily indicates the effort that the defense has put out tonight.
No doubt about that.
I'm going to steal your pen, Ron Cowan.
Oh, go ahead and steal it. We're going to vote for players of the game here, as it looks like Cruz is going to try to get into the end zone, and he is forced down short by Bryce Pila, loses his helmet, holds on to the football, will put his helmet back on. Cruz has had a good night for Arizona. He had that kickoff return for a touchdown. And, of course, he and Kyle Rowley both attended Brown University from the Ivy League. Don't know. I don't think they did it at the same time, though. I think Rowley was there a few years before.
Just a few.
Second down and goal at the two. It's a handoff to Cruz. Cruz, does he get in? Yes, he does. Touchdown, Arizona, with 11:42 to go in the game. And it is, well, another touchdown for the Rattlers.
Yeah, and, you know, they're scoring in the 60s, and that's nothing that is unusual for Arizona. I was going to say, I haven't seen the awkward interactions. Maybe that was that would be the case there.
I, you know, if they put us on the screen, you know what I'd do?
Punch me?
Fist bump.
Fist bump.
Oh, boom.
There we go. Well, you put your fist around, I thought, oh, you'll punch me. That seems excessive, but okay.
Anyway, it's fun to be here at the Moda Center to watch arena football. It's been an entertaining season. And don't forget June 21st, Star Wars theme. You bring your lightsabers. Bring the Force. Remember the Georgia Force arena football. Anyway, Dwayne Brooks on the kickoff return. He is belted as he gets to the 10-yard line. And it won't be a kickoff return for a touchdown this time. He can't do it every time, for gosh sakes.
I know. I mean, in that time, it was a one-arm tackle there. Jeremy Kellum, who gets my vote for defensive player of the game.
I agree with you.
Yeah.
Yeah, and by the way, Arizona, they win tonight. They improved to 9-2. They will host Orlando next Saturday in Phoenix, while the game between Portland and Spokane will be Sunday, Father's Day, right here. So no traveling.
No traveling. You
no
know,
traveling.
A little U.S.
team.
Open in the morning, a little football in the afternoon.
Who will win the U.S. Open?
Who will win the U.S. Open? Boy, that's tough. We'll go Rory.
Ooh, Rory. A lot of people think he might do it. Alex Carter, he is...
I'm going out on a limb there.
In trouble. He goes down at about the 9 with 10:07 to go in this one. It'll be a 2-yard loss. Carter decided to keep it instead of potentially throwing an INT.
Anthony McLeod, 6'2", 315. Ron, how'd you like to have that guy running at you at full speed?
I'm hoping I could outrun him. Because otherwise...
I don't know. Alex Carter couldn't that time.
Yeah, well, I'm just talking about running away. I'm not talking about stepping up in the pocket like Alex Carter. What a tough guy to hang in there. He goes back to pass. We have a whistle as he went back in a 7-step drop, and then the whistle blew. Let's see what... The cameraman from the... whether it's from Comcast Sports or the in-house video system, apparently... wanted to be part of the action too much. Illegal equipment. I haven't heard that call this season.
The real knife man. I'll tell you what.
Yeah. Problem is, Carter was about to bounce right off of him.
Yeah.
He was about to do a LeBron James.
We don't want that.
No.
We don't need any cut heads here. I guess they are wearing helmets, which helps a little bit.
Does help a little. Carter back to pass. In the pocket. Forced out. Finds a wide open Jared Perry at the 20. Jared to the 25, he's to the 20, he gets a block from Dwayne Brooks. Does he go in for 6?
Touchdown,
Portland Thunder, Jared Perry. However, way back at the line of scrimmage, there is a penalty. Will this stand? Here's Reggie Smith.
Flag on the play. Illegal defense, number 77. Illegal block. That penalty's declined.
All right. Touchdown, Portland Thunder. Nice move by Jared Perry, and he got a great block from Dwayne Brooks.
He did, and Dwayne Brooks sealed the edge, and he was able to get just enough space between him and the pads, and a great double move there, a nice little juke to get one defender down. Floyd not able to, he gets his hand on him. You know what? If Perry touched those pads, and he didn't, he missed it. Boy, football's a game of inches, and he missed
it
by inches. He would have been out of bounds, but a great move right at the center, right at the 25-yard line.
We're looking at an aerial of it, and it was very close, but the bottom line, touchdown. The extra point by Kevin Gessling is good. Timeout on the turf here at the Moda Center. 8:42 to go, Arizona 62, Portland 35. You're listening to Portland Thunder Football on 750-1029, the game.
And one touchdown away from your jack-in-the-box jumbo jack. Let's hear it.
Fans, please turn your... Thunder early on.
I love it. That's one play, 36 yards. The Oregon Driver Education Center, developing elite drivers. For more information, visit drivereducationcenter.com. Kickoff by Kevin Gessling, fumbled in the end zone by Cruz, who downs it. It'll be a first down for Arizona. So the ball hit the back wall, so the ball's dead. 8:32 to go and counting. Arizona with the ball and a 62-35 lead. Up by 27. What will be the philosophy? Looks like a new quarterback in for Arizona, number 3, Shane Boyd, out of Kentucky. So he's a Kentucky Wildcat.
Former SEC quarterback.
So he's played in some huge stadiums, big games. He's going to go deep.
To the official.
And he was going for, I believe, it was Reed. But nobody was there. In fact, Odiasi, I think, was the closest player to the ball.
Okay, I thought he was going for back judge Craig Faulkner.
Could have been.
He was wide open, and that was a pretty nice throw right his way.
And then but what if Faulkner would have caught the ball, would he try to return it? That's
you know, we've
question.
Seen that, right? We've seen, I remember a ref in a high school game, kickoff return, he leveled the guy.
He leveled, that's right. Second down and 10 for Arizona.
With flashback from his playing days.
7:35 to go. Reed in motion. Boyd back in the end zone. He's hit as he throws. And the ball's intercepted by Odiasi. There's a penalty flag. Odiasi goes into the end zone, throws the ball in the stands. It's kind of a Fernando Rodney arrow thing. But let's see what the call is.
There's two penalties.
There are two penalties. If they're offsetting, that means that play will not count. Let's see what happens.
Holding defense, number 4. Holding offense, number 70. Those penalties offset and play the down.
Boy, if that ball was tipped, though, and that's what the that's what Hayes is claiming.
Yeah, in fact, Lee Johnson, who's out in the field for Portland, the special teams coach, trying to get the attention of the officials, saying the ball was tipped. Some members of the offense are still out on the field for Portland.
And why is the official moving the ball to the 15? The ball should, the penalties are offsetting.
Yes,
yeah,
now he's
right,
bringing
there,
it back.
Buddy. I don't know if he's
he's confused. But now he's got his act
based
together.
Based on their flags, I think, is that Faulkner there still thinking that ball's coming in?
Yeah, he's still thinking about the glory days of high school.
Your defense wants it loud,
so
fans.
The protestations by the Portland bench to no avail. Rattlers with 6:54 to go. Have a second and 10. Boyd, quick pass out the left side. It's deflected. Well, actually, it goes off of the hands of Windsor. Meanwhile, deep in the backfield, Odiasi and Cruz with a little bit of collision and conversation.
It's two drops, by the way, from Rattler receivers. Windsor with one. I believe that Reed had the other one wide open from Davila. Davila should have another touchdown pass in this game.
Going to go into the stat sheet for Arizona and see how many passes Boyd has thrown this season. Looks like, as we see Boyd throw another bomb, Windsor's down there this time. He catches it at the 15. He's down to the 10. He's down to the 7-yard line. Boyd on the season was 25 of 43 coming into this game. So he's seen a little bit of action for the Rattlers, and that was an effective long pass that paid off with 5:48 to go.
Shane Boyd, another guy, a big body. He's only 6'1", but around 220 pounds.
He has kind of that Donovan McNabb look to him.
He does a little bit, yeah. Not easy to bring down, I'm sure.
First down and goal. Benson says, I'm going to try to run it to the end zone, and I'm going nowhere. Good pursuit by the defense of the Portland Thunder. It looks like Bryce Pila was in on it. Obi was close to the action.
Odiasi
was in there as well, so good pursuit.
Odiasi's a little banged up after that last play, the long throw to Windsor. He was slow to get up, and he is again. And Jeff Hole asked him if he wanted to come out, trainer. They were getting ready to substitute, and he said, I'm okay. Adjust his pads a little bit.
5 minutes to go here at the Moda Center. Portland trying to keep Arizona out of the end zone. Windsor in motion. Boyd back to pass at the 15. Fires it, and a good defense by Pierce. But the ball, I don't think, would have been caught by Reed. It was a little off target.
Yeah, carry big drop earlier in the game. Wonder if he's still thinking about that at all.
Could be. Could be as we now approach the 4:30 mark in this game.
The Rattlers,
third down and goal.
Rattlers are going to milk this clock for everything it's worth. You know, at this point of the game with 4:27 left, you know, that play clock's going to wind down to 3 or 2 before they hike
louder.
It.
Here we go. The play clock is at 6. Reed's in motion. Boyd at the 9-yard line. A quick pitch out to Cruz. Cruz finds the end zone for Arizona. He breaks a tackle, gets past Odiasi, gets past Pierce, and it's 6 more points for Arizona tonight, now with 4 minutes to go in this one.
One fan is still pretty amped up out there, as fans are starting to head for the exits here.
Tonight's crowd, 9,435. And I think the vast majority had a good time, an exciting game, but we really watched a championship team at work.
We did, and this is how championship teams do things. They keep their composure, they limit the penalties, and they score touchdowns.
The extra points good. 3 minutes and 30 seconds to go in this one. Arizona with a commanding 69-35 lead. We'll take a break.
Taking a look at some stats here, Ron. Alex Carter, 7 of 11, 102 yards, 2 touchdowns, does have the interception. Kyle Rowley, 9 of 20, 94 yards and 2 scores. So they've combined for 4 touchdowns, but, you know, combined their completion percentage is barely above 50, which isn't going to cut it against the defending champs.
16 of 31 as Brooks takes it off the net. He gets to the 5. He's going nowhere after that.
The Rattlers, Ron, have just been swarming on special teams. Saved 2 plays. One, there was a holding call. They have been great containing Brooks. And not only with the kickoff returns for touchdowns, but just in general, his return yardage has been minimal in this game. Now, He did return one, but overall, you know, the Thunder have not been starting the ball at the 25, at the 20, you know,
right,
in good territory. They've been back in their own, you know, pushed back a little bit here in this game.
They're at their own 8-yard line right now. It's 1st and 10 with 2:54 to go. Carter continues at quarterback. Brooks in motion. Carter back in the pocket, finds a wide open Jerry Perry, but he drops the ball. He was open, the ball was a little behind him, and as he rolled down on the ground, he could not maintain possession.
And I'm not sure, and this is the problem when you have a quarterback that hasn't worked with his receivers as much, is Carter, you know, launched that ball a little early. Yeah, it was a little bit behind Perry as well, but I don't think Jared was ready for that ball, which caused the drop as well.
Clock continues to run, 2:23 to go. Arizona 69, Portland 35. And the Portland offense has just not been on all cylinders tonight, no matter who the quarterbacks win. Credit the Arizona D-line for creating huge problems for Portland's quarterbacks. And there is when Alex Carter just leveled by big number 94, Tyree Glasper. He hit him hard. Man.
He did, and Sam Longo getting into it with McLeod down there. Longo, a new Portland Thunder member on the offensive line. And he had something to say after that play.
1:45 to go. Portland gathering up their thoughts and getting ready as the ball has been moved to the 2-yard line. 3rd down and 17 at the 2 for Portland with 1:32 to go. Of course, the clock will stop automatically, but now the play clock's down to 2, down to 1. He gets it off in time. Carter fires, tries to get it to Brooks, and the ball is intercepted. No, they say it's now incomplete. The ball hit the turf as I believe it's Kellum wants another INT.
Yeah, he's telling him to review that. That looked like a simultaneous hands on the ball, hits the turf. It was close. The official didn't have the best angle. He was a little bit behind the play, more towards his feet.
They're up. Let's see if it is an interception. No, I think
hit the turf first.
It did hit the turf first.
And they're going to challenge it anyway because, you know, you're up 34 points. Why not challenge a play with a minute to go in the game?
Right, with 1:02 to go.
He's challenged by Arizona. Further review.
And it's not going to get overturned.
So the play's under review.
So and I don't think the crowd's very happy with it. I mean, I get it. You want your player to have an interception. But at the same time, you're up 34.
Right.
What's the point?
Well, while we wait, let's just tell everybody about the fact that, hey, if you're looking for affordable, family-friendly entertainment this summer, the Portland Thunder offer a variety of ticket packages that fit every budget. Don't miss a second of the action. Go to portlandthunder.com And, of course, the next home game will be a week from Sunday from right here at the Moda Center. While we wait to see, and I agree with you, I mean, to review this play.
I mean, really? What?
Yeah.
I just don't understand the purpose behind it. If you're the Arizona Rattlers.
You got 1:02 to go, which means that in 2 seconds they'll have another break for the 1 minute break.
Yeah, I mean, I get it if the game's tight, but with a minute to go, I know that the Thunder have 3 timeouts. You know, at best they're scoring 21 points. Okay, 56-69 would still be the final score, assuming the Rattlers don't get the ball back.
Right.
It's just a little perplexing to me why you don't just let that one go and get out of this building here unscathed.
Jared Perry, 9 receptions, 150 yards for Portland, and 4 touchdowns. He's been really the key player on offense for Portland tonight, which I'm going to just describe as an uneven offensive performance against a brutal defensive line. Arizona's defensive line has really been the difference tonight.
It has. Arizona's, they put pressure on Rally. They've been able to put pressure on Carter. I mean, really, they've dominated the trenches both sides of the ball. Now, Davila, you know, he has had a bit of pressure on him, but not to the level where he's uncomfortable enough to make a mistake, as the official said back out on the field. I actually think I see someone talking into an Apple Watch, by the way, on the sidelines.
Here he is. Here's Reggie Smith.
Stand. Arizona's charged with their second challenge. They are out of challenge. They're also charged with a timeout.
So no more challenges for Arizona. They do have 2 timeouts left. Portland has all 3. And so with 1:02 to go, it's a 4th down and 17 for Portland. Alex Carter brings his troops up at their own 2-yard line. Ashford in motion. Carter back in the end zone. It's going to go for all the money. Brooks is held up. And it'll be a 1st down for Portland. Number 19 for Arizona, Marquise Floyd, an obvious pass interference call on Dwayne Brooks.
Saved a touchdown. Receivers will do that from time, or defenders will do that from time to time.
53.6 seconds to go, and that, I believe, will be our 1 minute warning.
Pass interference defense, number 19. 10-yard penalty, automatic 1st down.
So there's the automatic 1st down with 53.6 seconds to go. So now you say, here's the 1 minute
timeout.
And we will take a quick timeout and return to the Moda Center right after this on 750-1029 the game. Seconds to go. Arizona. They'll cruise back to the Valley of the Sun with their 9th win of the season. But with just 2 losses, Portland will drop to 3-8. But because of the quirky nature of the conference they're in, Brian, they're in the middle of the spot for the last 2 playoffs positions.
Despite
what happened tonight, because Spokane, last I saw, was losing tonight. You'll get an update on that score for us right now as Carter brings up the Thunder. He is tied up and he's taken down in the backfield for a sack. So Arizona just teeing off on the Portland offensive line. Anthony McLeod from Florida State takes care of business and gets a sack on Alex Carter. Carter talking to Mike Hohensee. It's a little maybe education session.
I have an update for you. This game is getting a little bit interesting here. The Shock just scored with 8:22 left in the 4th. Outlaws lead 55-49.
Ooh, it's a game.
We have a contest. There's no doubt about it.
So one of those teams will drop to 3-8 along with Portland.
Yeah. And 40s. You know, the Thunder still control their own destiny. Sorry, Ron.
No, they do. You're right. Because Spokane's coming here next week.
Yeah, and we'll break that down. Obviously, you'll be absent. Well, you'll be with me in one segment in Talking Thunder next week. But
that's
we'll,
right.
You know, I'll break down the standings and everything as well.
Carter in the end zone. Steps up. Throws deep for Ashford. And the ball is incomplete. And the clock stops with 40.4 seconds to go. And now we have a penalty flag, extracurricular conversation going on in the end zone amongst members of the offensive line. Tempers begin to flare. Cheap shots take place.
Foul defense, number 77. 10-yard penalty, automatic first down.
So Portland gets the first down. It's on the Rattlers.
Yeah, Antaj Hawthorne, a guy that's wreaked havoc. One of those guys you talked about, Ron, defensively, that's just been all over the field. You know, the stats aren't going to be there for him in terms of tackles, sacks, but he has had a huge impact on this game.
The entire Arizona defensive line, they've picked up some interceptions tonight as well. The defensive backfield, and Jeremy Kellum has had a great game.
The Outlaws just returned a kickoff for a touchdown.
So that's good for them. So they maintain their 61-49 now?
Yeah, 62 after the PAT.
Carter throws it deep. It's intended for Jared Perry.
And he's knocked on his keister again.
So 34.4 seconds to go. It's now second down and 10, Portland at their own 15-yard line. And another football thrown into the stands.
It's funny because the refs are trying to get it to the guy that controls the footballs, and fans keep jumping in front of him and taking them away.
9,345. At the Motor Center tonight to watch these two teams. Dwayne Brooks in motion for Portland, second down and 10. Carter has time. He's going deep again, and Brooks is all alone. It's a touchdown. Touchdown, Portland Thunder. Alex Carter to Dwayne Brooks with 25.3 seconds to go. Make it 69-41, Arizona. Nice pass.
Yeah, nice pass by Carter. He's had a couple of deep tries here that haven't gone his way. And Brooks just with a go route, and Arquise Brown gets embarrassed, as happens in arena football with the way that the deck is stacked towards the offense. But, you know, a nice way to end this game here for the Thunder, getting a score, putting the, you know, putting a little nice, neat little bow on this game, even though things didn't obviously end up the way they want. You know, you end on a high note, Ron. That's always good.
It is good, and because, of course, who might be the starting quarterback next week when Spokane comes to town? That'll be an interesting
quarterback
topic
gate
of conversation Tuesday night on Talking Thunder. 7 o'clock right here on 750-1029 the game. Extra points good. Solid night for Kevin Gessling. He's made all of his extra points. Here we go. Kevin Gessling. Let's see what he comes up with. If he'll kick it deep to Cruz. Here we go. He does kick it high. It's going to be a little short, about 5 yards deep in the end zone. Cruz takes it to the 5, and he just says, I'm going down. Looked like Pierce and Obi were down there along with Odiasi on the tackle, but now all basically Arizona has to do with 21.2 seconds to go, Brian, is get a couple of yards, and we'll see. I don't think Mike.
All they have
O&C
to do is move the, yeah, you know, I think at this point, don't you just want to get out healthy?
Yes.
You're not winning this game. I mean, let's face it. And obviously, I think that, Ron, when they kicked the ball away, that was the indication that the white flag is up.
All right, it is a keeper by Boyd. The clock continues to run because he picked up a yard, and that's going to do it here at the Motor Center. An entertaining game, an exciting game. We saw 3 kickoff returns for touchdowns, 2 by Arizona, and another one by Dwayne Brooks. But the clock ticks down 2-0 here at the Motor Center. The final score, Arizona 69, Portland 42. And we saw a team in the Arizona Rattlers tonight, Brian Perkins, that basically may have played one of their best games of the season, both on both sides of the football. And with special teams, too, because they got 2 kickoff returns for touchdowns. They got 3 interceptions on defense. And Nick Davila was on the money at quarterback.
Well, we're past the halfway point of the season. And, you know, this is when the Rattlers are going to really start to amp things up, get ready for the postseason. They still have a shot to get that top seed in the conference. You know, last season they didn't lose a game for, what, 13, 14, 15 games, something like that. You know, this year the storyline has been a bit different, but still at the same time, what you see is a team that's rounding into championship form here, and a team that the Thunder might have to face come playoff time. And, you know, whatever takeaways you can get is what's going to be the difference maker.
All right, so that's going to do it for our coverage of the game. We have our post
from the Portland Thunder, Jaren Perry's 9-yard catch. And tonight's AFL highlight of the game from the Portland Thunder, number 2, Dwayne Brooks' kickoff return.